I've got a program of research called Living with Hope, and it arose directly from my clinical practice. We've done about 18 studies now on hope at the end of life with palliative care patients and with their caregivers, and also developed programs to help them foster hope, because they see that their hope is threatened, but when they think about it, it's never gone. And what we're doing is trying to help them find it sometimes. It's hard to find when you have that diagnosis that your life is shorter than you think it might be. We say, can you describe a situation lately in which you've had hope? The doors just open and they talk, and their hope is for, there's multiple hopes that they have. And I think that's one of the privileges I've had of being a researcher looking at hope, is the wisdom that they've shared for the rest of us about hope and the hope that they have. So they talk about hope. It becomes very specific a lot of times. And their future, the hope is that possibility for a better future from this very difficult past and present, this difficult present. And because it's a possibility occurs in these hugely uncertain areas and times. And they talk about how when things are really uncertain, that it becomes specific and it becomes, their future is very short. So you know what? I hope in this moment I can breathe better. I hope in this moment that my pain might be eased. But it also is, I hope that my wife will be okay when I'm gone. I hope that my children, the future for my children, they have lots of, and for some, depending upon their faith, it's their hope for, sometimes it's for life after death. But overall, it's hope to have peace and comfort at the end of life. So they have multiple hopes at the same time. And if you think about it, the thing that happens to the rest of us, we use hope very lightly. If you listen, we use hope throughout our conversations throughout the day. We don't really think about it. But when your hope gets threatened, you become so much more conscious of it. And that's what they talk about. So they have amazing things to tell the rest of us about hope. I think the most important message in all of our hope research is no matter what happens to you, no matter where you are, there's always hope. And what you need to do is make it deliberate. Everybody uses the word, and we don't often think about it except for when it's threatened. So what you have to do is make it deliberate in your life. And all you have to do is ask yourself, what might give me hope today? And hope is about the little things. So it might be your hope for today might just be to look at a picture of someone you love. Or it might be to say to yourself, I don't care what happens, I'm going to listen to a piece of music. Or today I'm wearing red because it gives me hope.